Hi everyone, welcome to DFTW English, a unique voice to reveal another side of world affairs. Today, we talk about the tension between China mainland, the US and Taiwan. Recently, a think tank called the Center for a New American Security conducted a war game against the backdrop of a possible conflict in the Taiwan Strait. The think tank was established in 2007, based in Washington, D.C. It argued that in a conflict in the Taiwan Strait, the PLA would need to deal with the U.S., Japanese, and Australian coalition forces and Taiwan's Defense Army. The whole exercise was divided into three parts. First, the PLA will make a preemptive strike, knocking out important Taiwanese military forces. It will then focus on attacking U.S. military bases in Japan to prevent U.S. involvement, resulting in an escalated situation in the Taiwan Strait. The U.S., Japan, and Australia will send naval and air forces to form a joint force to intervene in the potential war. Eventually, it may evolve into a full-scale military confrontation between China and the U.S., leading to a nuclear war. In other words, the mainland's takeover of Taiwan may eventually turn into a situation of one against four. But the think tank completely ignores the People's Liberation Army's unique military thinking and style of action throughout the projection process. Unless the U.S. military and Japan has decided to take substantial action to interfere militarily in China's internal affairs, the possibility of the Chinese army taking the initiative to attack the U.S. military bases in Japan is relatively low. In a possible conflict in the Taiwan Strait, China's ballistic missiles are more than enough to keep extraterritorial forces at bay. As we mentioned several times in previous videos, China has the most potent rocket force globally, and its DF-21D, DF-26, and YJ-21 anti-ship missiles are more than enough to turn America's rusty surface warships into submarines. Also, China's intercontinental ballistic missiles with multiple warheads can cover every corner of the Earth. North America will not be a paradise anymore, as in World War I and II. The think tank mentioned above is a non-profit organization with the U.S. State Department as one of its primary donors. We do not think it can provide an objective and non-biased analysis in this regard. Before the People's Liberation Army makes further military exercises near the first island chain, the U.S. is compromised under stern warnings from the Chinese side. We uploaded a video last month, in May 2022, about the U.S. State Department's revision of its fact sheets regarding Taiwan, which omitted some key sentences like Taiwan is part of China and the U.S. does not support Taiwan's independence. The U.S. Department of State recently added back the description of the U.S. does not support Taiwan independence in its description of relations with Taiwan, a fatal blow to Taiwan's independence elements. It no longer emphasizes that Taiwan is an independent entity. Is the U.S. changing its policy toward Taiwan from strategic ambiguity to strategic clarity? It quietly made a mistake by deleting the sentence "does not support Taiwan independence" from its Taiwan relations fact sheets. It then stealthily corrected the mistake by adding back the words within a month. Since the U.S. Department of State revised its Taiwan relations fact sheets on its official website, China has begun an intensive counterattack in the diplomatic and military fields. At the diplomatic level, the Chinese Foreign Ministry criticized the U.S. at a regular press conference, saying that the U.S. is trying to hollow out the One China principle to cross the red line and support Taiwan's independence. Later, Yang Jiechai had a call with Sullivan, assistant to the President for National Security Affairs, stressing a red line for the United States that if the U.S. insists on playing the Taiwan card, it will be held accountable for subverting bilateral relations and that on the Taiwan issue, the Chinese side means what it says. It will also do what it means. On the military level, the Chinese aircraft carrier Liaoning and the Chinese Eastern Theater have organized several large-scale drills around the island of Taiwan. The Chinese carrier aircraft took off more than 300 times from the Liaoning aircraft carrier, and each of them returned safely to the deck without falling into the sea, performing much better than the F-35 fighters. The Chinese have shown the United States through practical actions that they are determined to protect their sovereignty and capable of doing what they say. The U.S. wants to maintain a status quo of no independence, no unification on both sides of the Taiwan Strait because it can continue to play the Taiwan card to contain the mainland. At the same time, it can use the Taiwan independence elements to squeeze every penny out of Taiwan continuously. During his visit to Taiwan to sell more Boeing planes, U.S. Congressman Graham warned the Taiwanese authorities not to provoke Beijing too much, which shows how eager the Taiwanese authorities are to seek independence now. If not controlled well, a handful of Taiwan independence politicians on the island will drag the United States, Japan, and Australia into a hopeless war with Beijing's central government. U.S. Secretary of State Antony Blinken's speech on China policy once again clarified that he does not support Taiwan independence. However, he used Washington's One China policy to undermine Beijing's One China principle. Even though the U.S. side was forced to say it does not support Taiwan independence, it does not mean it will give up playing the Taiwan card to contain China's rise. The U.S. will continue to use Taiwan to create regional unrest, so it can drive money out of Asia to save the Wall Street and sell weapons to China's neighboring countries. Fortunately, most Asian countries do not want to confront China, so none of them wants the U.S. to deploy middle-range missiles pointing at China. Even the South Korean government stressed that the THAAD system is to defend, not attack. Japan is the only nation eager to use the geopolitical tension in the West Pacific to restore its military strength and ambition, and it is also capable of creating problems in East Asia. Hardly can the U.S. rely on Japan to win a war against China, we believe. On the contrary, the belligerent Japanese government may involve the U.S. troops in a hopeless and aimless war with the world's most formidable army near the first island chain. The Chinese army gets impatient when it becomes unprecedentedly robust militarily. America's two followers, Canada and Australia, complain about Chinese pilots' aggressiveness toward their aircrew in the East and South China Seas. Canadian pilots even claim their Chinese counterparts approach them so closely that they could even see them show middle fingers. The distance between Canadian and Chinese warplanes was as short as 6 to 30 meters. We must admit that Chinese pilots performed flawlessly, like acrobats and gymnasts in the air or seagulls near the Chinese coastline, several thousand miles away from Canada. Even if they showed their middle fingers as their Canadian counterparts claimed, they were probably clearing their nostrils, not to show their contempt to strangers. They likely approached the Canadian surveillance plane because of curiosity, as our cat observes us whenever we put anything into our mouths. 70 years ago, the Chinese soldiers neither had thick cotton padded clothes and the frigid temperature as low as 30 degrees under zero, nor did they have air forces to protect them when fighting 16 United Nations armies in the Korean War. Even if there is a battle for Taiwan's unification, and the Chinese mainlanders have to fight four armies, they will have enough confidence and strength to win the war again. Thank you so much for your continuous support. Your precious time with us is highly appreciated. We do our work as a mission, a cause. Please help us grow and reach more extensive audiences by forwarding our content to as many people as possible. We publish videos daily and post long videos on topics viewers are interested in once or twice a week. If you have not subscribed to our channel or turned on the notification bell, please do it now, so you will not miss our new content daily. Please use the PayPal or Patreon link below, or scan the QR codes to support us.